Good morning, students. I am K. Sudha from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss one of the important topic from business economic subject, that is pricing. So you all, in my previous classes, we have studied about cost, output and production. So pricing plays a very important role in the for a company. Pricing plays a very important role for a company, because here if we go for undervaluation of the price or overvaluation of the price, then that is going to be a problem for the company. If we are going for undervaluation or if we are going for overvaluation, so pricing plays a very important role. It is a key important factor for the management, for the managers of the organization, fixing the pricing. So in the process of fixing the pricing, before telling you about the methods of pricing and different types of pricing, first let us understand the major meaning of pricing. What is pricing? Okay, my topic is pricing. Okay. So which pricing it is? Selling pricing. Selling price of a product. Selling price of a product. So the selling price of the product should not be overvalued or it should not be undervalued. It should not be overvalued as well as it should not be undervalued. If it is overvalued, you will lose customer. The company is going to lose customer. If it is undervalued, then you are going to lose your profits. Okay, for example, let us say that overvalued. See, your selling price you have fixed as 10 rupees. Okay, the cost price say that it is 12 rupees. So are you going to get profit or loss? You are getting loss. 2 rupees is the loss what we are getting. So you should not do undervaluation of the product. Undervaluation of the product as well as overvaluation of the product. So to avoid this problem, what we are doing? We are, the manager of the organization is going to use the best method of pricing. What the manager is doing? The manager of the company is fixing the best method. He is finding out the best method of fixing the pricing. Okay, so here in the pricing method, we have to understand one very important thing, that is the objective of the pricing. Objective of pricing. So in this objective of pricing, what can be the objective of pricing? The objective of pricing should be, it should attract customer. First objective is customer. By seeing the price, the customer should get attracted. By seeing the price, customer should get attracted. Okay, the customer should get attracted by seeing the price. So here, say that one company is selling the product at 10 rupees, X product. Another company is selling the product at 12 rupees. At 12 rupees, customer is going to get attracted towards which particular product? Towards X product or towards Y product? He is going to get attracted towards X product. Why? Because the price of this is less than the other company's product. So that's why the objective of pricing is, the major objective is to attract the customer. After that, see the second one. What is the second very important one? That is maximization of profits. Maximization of profit. So here, whenever the company is fixing the price, they have to focus on maximization of profit. What they have to do? They have to fix the maximization of profit. They have to get maximum profit. So in such a way, they have to fix the price. After that, third one is customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction. So here generally when you observe few products, you will you are not satisfied by paying the price because you are thinking that the price at which you have purchased the product is more. You are not satisfied with the price and next time you are not going to purchase the product as you are not satisfied with the price. So here the objective of pricing is what? Now, customer satisfaction. Customer should get satisfied with the price what we have made. After that, next one, Seema, fourth very important one is market share. What is the meaning of market share? Market share means among all the competitors in the market who are selling the product, your market share should be major. You should be able to occupy major profits. Okay, so that is also one of the important objective of pricing. So I think you all are clear with the pricing objective. What are they? They are customer. It should attract the customer. Second one is maximization of profit. Third one is customer satisfaction. Fourth one is maximum market share. So these are the four important objectives of pricing. Okay. After that one, next one. After this, next topic in pricing is pricing methods or different types of pricing. Okay, pricing methods or different types of pricing. So what can be the pricing method? You have observed the different types of pricing method, like market skimming, market penetration, the profit is more, or the different types of pricing methods are there. So let us see the first one more, that is cost-based pricing. First type is cost-based pricing. So in the cost-based pricing, the first one is cost plus pricing. Okay, cost plus pricing or cost plus profit. So under this cost plus pricing method, what we will do, we are going to find out the cost price of the product and to that we will add the profit and after that we will get the selling price. After that, what we are doing, we are getting the selling price. Say that the cost price means it is the price at which the product is produced. So that is the cost price. To this cost price, what we are doing, say that the company is targeting for profit as 2. So now what is the selling price? The selling price is 10 plus 2, that is 12 rupees. 12 rupees is the selling price. So this is the basic pricing method. What is that? Cost plus pricing method. That is cost price plus profit is equals to selling price. Okay, after the second one, is marginal cost method. Okay, marginal cost pricing method. So marginal cost pricing method is also called as break even pricing method. It is also called as break even pricing method because in the marginal cost pricing method, what we are doing, we are going to take one of the important cost, that is variable cost. We are going to consider one of the important cost, that is variable cost. Okay, so to this variable cost, we are going to add this variable cost to the total cost. Whenever there is an increase in the cost or decrease in the cost, that cost is called as a variable cost. So while doing pricing, we are going to consider this variable cost. So these are the two important methods under cost-based pricing. After that, second one, seeing it is competition-oriented pricing method, competition oriented pricing method. So under this, the first one is sealed bid pricing method. Sealed bid pricing method. Sealed bid pricing method, I think you all know about tenders and quotations. Tenders and quotations. This is related to what? This is related to the contracts. When few companies, they are unable to do the work on their own, what they do? They will give that work to some other company, that is contracts. So to get that contract, the company has to give tenders and quotations. Okay, quotations they have to send to the company. Whichever company is giving, whichever company is quoting the less price, less selling price, the tender is given to that particular company. The contract is given to that company. So that is called as what? That is called as sealed bid pricing method. That is called as sealed bid pricing method. Why it is sealed bid? Because that quotation is closed in an envelope, and in a general meeting all the quotations are going to be opened. So that is your sealed bid pricing method. After that, second one, after sealed bid pricing method, the second one is going rate pricing method. So what is going rate pricing method? Going rate pricing method means, ma, whatever is the market price of the related goods, market price of the related goods. Like, let us talk about toothpaste. There are many companies which are selling the toothpaste. Or let us talk about, rather than toothpaste, let us talk about some vegetable or a fruit. Okay. Let us talk about a fruit, that is apple. Apple. So here, what is the price of the apple? Say that the price of the apple sold by X company is, say that 20 rupees. One apple cost is 20 rupees. If you want to sell, if Y want to sell apple, at what price he is going to sell? He is going to sell the product at this price only. He cannot sell the product at more price, or he cannot sell the product at less price. Why? Because apple comes under perfect market, and whatever price has been determined by the market forces, we have to sell the product at that price only. So that is called as going rate pricing method. That is called as going rate pricing method. Is it clear to everyone? Okay. So after that, so these are the two methods. What are they? In competition oriented pricing method, sealed bid pricing, as well as going rate pricing method. Next, see the third one. Demand oriented pricing method. So under this one, the first one is what, ma? The first one is price discrimination. Price discrimination means charging the price. Under price discrimination, what we will do? We are going to charge the price to the customer. Customer has to pay us the price of the product. But here, based on the customer, the price is going to vary. The price is going to vary based on the customer. For example, a very good example, ma, your LPG gas cylinders. Okay, cylinders. So here, what is happening under LPG gas cylinders? You have seen, ma, we are giving, the government is giving the gas cylinder at a subsidy rate as well as at a non-subsidy rate. Okay, few people they are enjoying the subsidy, few people they have left the subsidy. So what is that? That is your price discrimination. If you observe few other product also, few other product also there. You will see ma in packaging of the product. At the back you can easily observe in the packaging of the product. In Karnataka the price is 12 rupees. In AP the price is 10 rupees. Why? Because based on the customer there is a variation in the prices. Okay, so that is called as price discrimination. Based on the target customer, the price of the product is changing. The quantity is not changing, but what is happening, only price of the product is changing. So that is called as price discrimination. Okay, after price discrimination, the next one is perceived value pricing method. Perceived value pricing method. What is perceived value pricing method? Perceived value pricing means ma, based on the assumptions of the customer, based on the thinking of the customer. Okay, few customer can think that the price what they are paying is above the market price. Few customer, they can think that it is below the market price. So we have to make our product price based on the perception of the customer. So that is your perceived value pricing method. After these two methods, ma, that is in demand oriented, we are having next two methods. What are they? Price discrimination method, and next one is perceived value pricing. Price discrimination means the price of the product is going to be different for the customer. Based on the customer, the prices are going to vary. What is perceived value pricing method? Perceived value pricing method is the next very important one. Based on the perception of the customer, the prices are going to change. Okay, after that, next one ma is your fourth one, that is based on the strategy. Strategy based pricing method. Okay, in strategy based pricing method, first method is market skimming. What is market skimming? See, market skimming, or you can if you have ever taken butter from the curd, from the buttermilk, if you have taken butter, you will see that what is that cream. Okay, in that way only companies, they are going to target on the creamy layer of the customer. Okay, so on the that particular creamy layer only we are going to target. How we are going to target? We are going to target by fixing more price at the initial stage. You have seen for the technological products, ma. Like, let us talk about your iPhones, Apple phones. The price is at the initial stage is going to be very high. But after 1 year or after 2 years, the prices are going to get reduced. So that technique is your market skimming. After that, second one, market penetration. In this market penetration, the product price at the initial stage, at the introduction stage, is going to be very less. But as the customers are getting habituated to the product, as they are becoming loyal to the products, what will happen to the price? The price will get increased. So that is your market penetration. Okay, so you will observe this in the FMCG goods, and this market penetration in the technological goods. Okay, so here in the market skimming, in the initial stage, the prices are going to be very high. In the market penetration, the prices are going to be very low. Okay, so both are profit oriented. So these are the different methods of pricing. Thank you, students.